How's it going, guys? Welcome back to Moonlighter. Someone pointed out in the comments, I found these swords. I didn't know what the heck I was supposed to do with them. There's like no descriptions for them. They just seem totally useless to me. Someone pointed out that it's now a basis that I can use at the blacksmith to upgrade weapons. So right now it's just like it's a basic useless slab of a sword. It's like someone just found a sword laying around in the rubble, you know, a naturally forming sword and a naturally occurring mineral, like a diamond or a piece of granite or a piece of, I don't know geology, but sometimes swords just grow, and then you gotta take it to the blacksmith and get it polished up and turned into something useful. But I'm gonna throw one up for sale, and then I can worry about maybe trying to get the other one polished up. Or whatever needs to be done with that. This thing, I swear I sold it for way too cheap. Yeah. These need to sell for like a grand. I got all this hardened steel that sells for a lot of money. I'll keep that at 300 because that's what people like. I can make... Oh, whoops, I didn't mean to exit. I meant to open up the shop. I just wanted to look outside and see if there was people patiently waiting for me. I know people have been eager to watch episodes of the series. Maybe people have been eager to come and check out what new wares I have in my shop. Each day I'm getting more valuable, cool shit. I'm the only one in this town who's willing to go deep down to the dungeon. Damn, I think I sold the sword for way too cheap. But at least now I know. Okay, I overshot with 1,000. Let's bump that back down then. Yeah, they super disliked it. I could have swore that this thing was worth like a ton of money. 170, people were really pumped about that. Bring that down a little bit. It's too bad I sold the sword for too little, but hey, every time it's a learning experience. You find out what people are willing to pay. Like that. I sold the white rock for too little last time. That time I sold it for a price that people were happy with. They were into it. I should look at what's like the popularity on this. Oh, it's popular. Popular. I'm gonna put it up a little bit more even then, because people might be willing to go outside of their comfort zone if it's a new hot item that people are gonna be looking for. Throw some of these crystals for sale. I don't want to throw away, like, sell all of my hardened steel. I probably want to put some of that in storage, because I want to start worrying about, you know, upgrading. Damn it. Still tears. Tears over the ruins. I want to worry about upgrading, making sure I have better gear and stuff. And if I'm selling all my stuff for way too cheap, I'm not going to have enough money. If I'm selling everything, then I'm not going to have enough, you know, hardware. Oh, he's still crying. Damn it, I suck at this. Why can I not price this one out properly? Ah, I just could have sworn it was worth so much. Well then, let's get it down to 420. It's always my favorite go-to if no one can decide what the heck they're willing to pay. People are always willing to pay 420. That's the perfect price for any product. Except for this one, but for most other products, it is the perfect price. Ah, damn. I really thought that after all of this reductions, I would find something that was just a regular sad and someone would be willing to buy. But no, damn all these people. They keep just bitching over it over and over again. I gotta look at the popularity of the crystals. No one's even looking at them. Low popularity. So that was a good price for people, but no one cares right now. No one gives a shit about this item. I've had some requests to do longer episodes of the series, and that's something I'd like to do for you guys. People are super into the series right now. I'm super into playing it. So I would... There we go. Finally, I got a mopey buyer. So doing longer episodes would be great. I would love to give that to you guys if that's what you're looking for, since there's usually time between individual episodes. The more content I can give, the better in that case, right? One thing is that people might not realize just from watching it how much editing is in these small little like 15 minute episodes. There's a lot of downtime usually in the shop here. Like one run of the shop, I don't know, takes 4 or 5 minutes or something. And usually I edit that down to 3. I'm talking a lot more today because I have a lot to say, I suppose. But yeah, usually there's a lot of downtime with people just kind of looking around the shop like this, not doing anything, and me adjusting prices and things like that. I've been trying to trim a lot of that content out, and so I'd like to do longer episodes for you guys. I'll try, but I can't really promise that. Just because it makes more work for me, and to a level that is pretty difficult for me to maintain in a lot of ways. Well, you know what? That wasn't the most successful day. I really thought we were going to get more out of that than we did. I stick my steel and rocks and things that are worth money all in here. I'm just sticking everything in there. I don't care. All I'm going to hang on to is that sword and that potion. Going to go run down into the dungeon. And then when I get back out of there, I can take the sword to the blacksmith. And maybe I can learn a little bit about what it'll take to upgrade that sword. Because right now I'm still just using this little dagger, this little like tutorial dagger that you get. Man, thank goodness I'm not still using that broom that I was using for a long, long time. Yeah, I'd really love to have like a nice, cool upgraded sword though that I can start using instead. That seems like it would be great. Two episodes ago, episode 4 of this, God damn it. I asked people maybe for a little bit of help with like naming the different creatures that you fight in this game. Because there's a lot of them and I was just kind of making stuff up on the spot. And in episode 5 I didn't use any of those because 4 and 5 were recorded at the same time. So my apologies if people were expecting to see some of their name suggestions show up and I didn't use any of them. I'll try to use some of the ones that stuck. The pots are probably, I can't think of something hateful enough to name those stupid pots. They are the worst thing about this game. I hate them so. I've gotten much better at managing them. No name suggestions for these golems. They basically are just golems. But the guys flying around. Ooh, I got it. Oh, damn it. I thought I could get a nice angled dive in there and maybe collect some of that stuff before it fell into the pit. Nope, I suck. These guys I was calling like claw machines. Someone suggested maybe a helicopter and someone else said chopper. I like chopper because they fly like helicopters, but they're like knives, right? They're like flying around with knife arms. So chopper was kind of like a nice dual meaning thing. It worked well in that sense. How many times can I fall into the pit in one run? Let's see, I don't know. Try and set a record, I guess. I don't have foundry rest. I keep running out of it, so I gotta make sure I keep that up in my top thing there, where if I die, I get to keep it, because it's useful for crafting. Keep running out of it. I really hope I find a fountain, because I got my ass kicked in that one little room. What was I even doing? Come on, you stupid golem. I'm just trying to do my sweet divey dash rolls on you. Whoa! Yeah, that's another thing that I can buy. What happened? I need to equip this. There we go. That's what I wanted. And I would like to equip this, please. Now I finally get to test out a new item. Oh man, you can get some quick successive attacks in with this guy. Oh, he uses this one like he does the broom. So you get all the quick jabs from it, and he also does his like charging attack where he runs at things. So this could be good. I could give this a shot for a little while. It does pretty much the same damage, I think. I don't have the ability to use my shield. Let's get real. I basically never use my shield anyways, so not necessary in my eyes. But there is like a nice range, like a wide arc when he swings his sword, which I don't know if he has here. So I don't know if I can kill pots with the spear. Good. You can see he kind of starts out to his left and brings it in front to the center. So with that little bit of a sweep there, it's just enough to make sure that you get the attacks off on the pot. Fuck you! That was a shitty placement. I'm not gonna fuck with that. Come on, big pool fountain thing. I Papa needs a bath. I don't know why I would call myself Papa. Never, maybe because of the white hair, but I've literally never done it yet. Didn't really feel like the time to start. But I went for it nonetheless. Sometimes the nicknames just choose you rather than you choosing the nicknames. I don't know what the fuck I'm talking about. I rarely do. Just chop up my bushes. I'm liking the spear. Probably gonna hang on to the spear for like the foreseeable future. Yeah! I think there's this like more or less confirms for me that there's one of these healing fountains on every, or always on the first level at the very, very least. I think I found one every time I've gone looking for it. You know, for a while there I didn't know to look for them, so those don't really count. But since I decided that I wanted to start looking for those, I think I've consistently found them. I think I can keep these guys at bay with the spear without them using their sword attacks on me. That's the best thing about the spear so far in my eyes, is that I don't have to worry about those motherfuckers getting super close to me, because I've been killed by the golems possibly more than any other thing here. Come on. Oh, I got lucky that other time, didn't I? That I lined that up super well, like, without even really trying. Seems like it's actually a secretly a bit of a pain to get it just right. There. You saucy bitch. You big saucer of bitchery. Oh, and I didn't even look at the chest yet. Cool, I guess. I got a lot of stuff in the trunk here. A lot of junk in this trunk, I think is what I'm trying to say. Just another soldier bow, right? Like, I don't think there's any way I can check and see if one is stronger, does more damage than the other one, anything like that. So I guess I just keep going with it as is. Oh, I've been dilly-dallying a bit too much. I can take a hint. But I do kind of just want to finish up this level here and try and open up that chest if I can. No. Stupid pot blocking my way. Can I fight this thing? Like, I don't think I really want to fight this thing, but I can. It's an option, at least. Well, I am not doing too hot here. Lots of damage, quick together. Fuck this. I mean, it like doesn't even make a sound. Oh shit. That was fucking dumb. Oh no, I lost a lot of good stuff again when I look at it. Look at me. I lost my training sword and sealed. I'm actually stuck with the spear now. That's my new thing. I guess the spear is what I use now. Yeah, it sounded like when I attacked that ghost dude, it would show a little, you know, a 25 on the screen or whatever to show that I did damage, but it didn't even really make a sound. There was no, like, impact sound whatsoever. So that makes me think that I probably can't actually hurt that thing. Well, that didn't go very well. I don't know if it's really worth doing another run of the shop right now. I got a fair amount of gold. What I think I'm gonna do instead is try and talk to you. Oh, but I just lost that foundry rest that I had found and all that shit. So I guess I just want to see what you can do for me sword-wise. Hey! Yeah, so this is that base sword, and now here's like the upgraded one. You can see, yeah, that one doesn't even have a name. Oh, but I have to like recraft a starting sword and shield. It's good to know that option's available at least, you know, so I can get something going there. Man, look at some of the stuff I could have got, but I don't even know what that, you know, the requirements of items here. I don't even know what the second and third one are. It's a different version of that auxiliary cord. So yeah, I don't know what either of those are. What do I need? I need an auxiliary cord thing for this one in order to upgrade that. And eventually it looks like I need an ocarina. Five of them? It's kind of what it looks like, right? But I want the Buster Big Sword. I have most of what it takes. Next time I find one of those auxiliary cords, fuck, it takes 10 grand. Oh my god. Why are upgrades so expensive? Nuts. Well, thank you for the tip in the comments, though. Now I at least know how I'm meant to be dealing with that. Let me just go do some quick cash grabbing from these trees. Then I won't even need to worry about opening up the shop. I'll get the quick, like, 6 or 7 coins. Perfect. Then that I'll try and haggle the guy down to something like that. Something in the in that more affordable 6 coin range rather than that much out of my price range 10,000 that he was asking. Oh good. I did take foundry rests with me. I was smart enough to put them somewhere where I wouldn't lose them when I died. So good going me. Oh, none of this. The good prices I found for that aren't even worth it. I'm not going to bother opening the shop right now. So next time, guys, I am not going to open the shop. I'm going to go run straight back down into the dungeon. I'm going to that second level of the dungeon as quickly as I can, possibly the third. I got to start progressing down into the dungeon and finding more crafting materials, more valuable things, because right now, the last couple episodes, I feel like I've been stuck on like a little bit of a rinse and repeat. I need to start worrying about actually progressing further in the game. So, thank you guys so much for watching. I'll see you again soon.